40 million exposed in a UK cyber attack. Android 14 stops Stingrays, and CPUs across brands are susceptible to hacks. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for August 15th, 2023. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Let's go ahead and jump right into the news this week. The UK Electoral Commission recently disclosed information on a massive data breach that exposed the personal information of folks who registered to vote between 2014 to 2022. The breach was actually detected way back in October of 2022, but the attackers had already been doing some recon on the commission systems since August of 2021. Now, this cyber attack opened the door to the commission's email servers, control systems, and even copies of electoral registers. And that's not all. This breach gave the threat actors access to names, addresses, email addresses, phone numbers, you name it. They even snagged personal images. That's kind of creepy. Anyone who registered to vote anonymously, your secrets are safe. And if you are wondering, did this mess with the election? No, it did not. The electoral process and voter registration dodged the bullet, thankfully. But here's where it gets interesting. The commission downplayed the issue, saying that much of that data is already publicly available. Certainly some of it is public, like names and addresses. But those email addresses and phone numbers, that's prime bait for phishing attacks and identity theft, as that data was not in the public domain. So if you are a UK voter, brace yourself because phishing is coming. Call up the organization and check if it's legit if you do get some kind of suspect emails. 40 million people were impacted, and that's a whole lot of personal information floating around. Now, why did it take the commission 10 whole months to disclose this breach? Well, they claimed that they had to investigate the intrusion, see just how bad the breach was, and then lock down their digital systems. This compromised data could be used with other public info to create accurate profiles of folks. They are saying that it won't mess with the elections or your voter status, but don't let your guard down just yet. The commission's urging anybody who registered to vote between 2014 to 2022 to stay sharp. Watch out for your data being used or abused. In the meantime, they have increased their defenses to block future cyber attacks. Google is working on making the next iteration of Android, Android 14, more secure when connecting to cellular networks. Coming soon, this new feature for Android 14 compatible smartphones will allow you to disable 2G network support and disable support for null cipher or unencrypted connections at the modem level. Now, this is a part of the Android security model, which works to prevent things like packet injection, tampering, and eavesdropping by only allowing end-to-end encrypted connections. As we have known for some time, 2G towers have got some weak encryption and lackluster authentication, making them prime targets for attackers. A great example of this is Stingrays, those cell site simulators that trick your phone into connecting to a fake tower. Stingrays can intercept your calls, your texts, even your data usage by using a downgrade attack to force the 2G connection. The new Android 14 feature will block that from happening by preventing downgrades. Now, the ability to disable 2G at the modem level was originally introduced in early 2022 with Android 12 as an option, and it can be found under your settings, network and internet, SIMs allow 2G. The new setting will include an option to select your SIM, but now device fleets like those in enterprises or government agencies will be able to restrict the entire set of devices. Disabling null cipher connections stops snooping on circuit-switched voice calls and SMS messages. The update will allow users to disable support for null cipher connections at the modem level as well if a device supports the newer radio hardware abstraction layer, which is also called HAL or HAL. In both of these cases, emergency calls will still be able to downgrade to 2G or null cipher, so you will be able to contact emergency response if you are out of range of newer towers. Biggest of shoutouts to my Patreon supporters, especially my golden s'mores and their fur babies for making this show possible, since we don't have ads on the show at all except for Patreon. Become a part of the s'mores over at patreon.com/Shannon Morse. That page will give you early access to these videos, a private Discord group, a monthly live streamed Q&A session, and a lot more. Now, if you are currently a patron over on the ThreatWire Patreon page, switch on over to the new one so you don't lose access to your perks. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story, all about CPU vulnerabilities. Now, these sound kind of like movie titles, but they are vulnerabilities. There's Collide Power, Downfall, and Inception. Each of these attacks stems from a vulnerability in CPUs. Modern processors are leaking data through side channel attacks. Now, Downfall is the first one. This targets a weakness in billions of Intel processors. It's tracked as CVE-2022-40982, and this can allow a malicious app to snoop on and steal your passwords, encryption keys, and more. Even Intel's software guard extensions, or their SGX, cannot keep this one out. But how does it happen? Well, it's all about memory optimization in your processor. So think of it like an unlocked door that lets one program sneak into another space. Two malicious processes built by the researcher gather data sampling and gather value injection can be used to bypass isolation barriers and steal data from other programs. Gather itself is a process that's built into the CPU for memory optimization, but the researcher found a vulnerability in this process, allowing for them to perform an attack. The research was disclosed to Intel, and they are releasing a microcode update to patch this leaky problem. If you are using Alder Lake, Raptor Lake, or Sapphire Rapids, you are in the clear. Other families of CPUs are vulnerable, specifically Skylake, Tiger Lake, and Ice Lake. AMD CPUs are susceptible to kernel memory leaks due to Inception. This is a transient execution attack tracked as CVE-2023-20569. Inception tricks the CPU into taking incorrect actions by leaking arbitrary kernel memory at a rate of 39 bytes per second. This affects all AMD Zen CPUs, including the newest Zen 4 models, and AMD has provided microcode patches and additional mitigations. Now, lastly, meet Collide Plus Power, or Collide Power. This attack is a software-based method that can leak arbitrary code, and it can work on any device powered by any processor, thanks to the way that shared CPU components combine data from several applications, which results in a leaked signal in power consumption. So the attacker can force a collision between their own malware and the legit data on a target machine in the CPU's cached memory. This is a concept, but likely will not be used in the wild because the data retrieval is very slow. I'm Shannon Morse. Stay vigilant, stay secure. I have a cough. I hope it didn't sound too terrible. I'll see you on the internet. Bye.